Follow me. We need to get him to the car.
He's the most important man in the universe.
Protect this child fucker!
You've done that, what, in three other cases so far, so...
Basically.
You go out there, Bukowski. You handle it.
Like, all the criminals in Los Angeles are like, hey, man, if you're into child stuff, just make sure that Cole Phelps is on the case. You'll go scot-free.
For some reason, he never arrests you. It's really comforting.
And Colby, like, no, that's the I was just following procedure. I couldn't arrest that guy because he had diplomatic immunity. That's right. Cole Phelps, child pornography lover. No.
Sorry. That's child pornographer lover.
Yeah, child pornographer lover.
That was not what I wanted.
That's fine. As long as you didn't shoot the child pornographer.
Yeah, don't shoot him. Then you'll fail the case.
Defend him with your life.
It is your sworn honor as...
Those are police. Don't shoot those.
Yeah. Shoot all of them. Yeah, you shot that guy in the ass. He's dead.
Wow, Cole, you shot so many of those gangsters right in the back. You get a promotion.
You shot them in their soul. If you see someone dressed in blue, just start screaming and shoot him.
Let's see if that guy's gonna pop out to shoot that cop man.
Trying to make him only shoot that cop. Yeah, they did it for you. Made you do your cool reload pose.
Hero.
Now this is what I call a result.
So many dead bodies.
Mark Bishop, erstwhile film producer, an all-around piece of shit, catches a fast ticket to Quentin for statute rape and attempted murder. So he gets to spend the next 15 years playing sissy. Instead of sticking it to little girls.
15?
That is justice with capital J, Detective Phelps. You developed such a reputation.
Attempted murder gets you 15?
You're getting promoted. Go on, get
attempted murder? What is that? They don't give a Nobel Prize for attempted chemistry, do they?
Big promotion.
Bukowski gets nothing.
Alright, so he was happy with most of my results. He only yelled at me once.
And that was a DLC case. If you were playing the base game, it would have been immaculate.
It would have been super promotion. Hey, I'm really angry
you
that
gotta
you did well.
You've got to be pleased with these results.
You've seen Phelps, never before
Bukowski,
seen results.
This your work? Can I help you, detective? Sorry, Cap. Didn't see you there.
Yeah, I'll bet you didn't.
This is a traffic case. You need something?
I'm here to buy a drink for the two LAPD traffic cops who broke the back of Guy McAfee's private army. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Captain?
Well, drinking on the job, I do.
No, I don't.
I'm buying.
Am I under this fuck now?
No.
Okay.
No.
The Blue Room Jazz Club.
Fucking hate Roy so much.
A lot of movie people hang out here. You like jazz, Cole? The hopheads love it.
Sure, I guess.
Big bands and swing, I can understand, but this bebop palaver? How are you supposed to dance to that?
I hate you, Roy.
This is Phelps, Leroy. Be nice to him. You'll like this place. They treat you right. You like a table, Roy? What do you think we want to do? Stand at the bar like
I'll
chumps?
I'll get a table ready for you.
Don't look so happy to see me, Alphonse. I might get the wrong impression. Cole, this is
you
Alphonse.
You see, sir, it's because
He's
we all
a French
hate you.
Negro from Africa. Can you beat that?
The Congo.
A pleasure to meet you, Alphonse.
Canadian Negro from Grenada?
She has the next set.
Come on, Cole, you can meet
it's
Elsa.
Like someone like random on the character generator. Like
Roy has been a fucking I can beat that. Cunt. She's to be to every single person he has spoken to in this scene.
What to do or what not to do, Alphonse.
Alphonse just tried to step it up, though.
Don't spoil it.
If you will follow me, detectives.
It's called Cottonmouth.
Oh, Roy.
It was my only real friend, Holland. We went through it all.
So here's that doctor we've been saying.
You have no idea. You said it was construction work.
It was an industrial accident, Elsa.
I've always wanted to argue with someone in a mirror.
Elsa, are you going on?
Louis, for God's sake, he was my best friend. The only man who ever loved me without putting his hands on me.
Hi, Elsa. Here's someone I'd like you to meet. Cole Phelps.
This guy is a mile a minute.
Yeah, no, like, gotta keep moving.
Another fascist from the LAPD.
Sorry about this, Cole.
Yeah, foreign actress.
What an evening
of
I'm
course.
Having. First a Negro puts his hands on me, and then this.
And there's the punctuation mark at the end of the sentence.
Never forget your place with me again.
What a lovely, lovely person.
Evening, Doc.
She's a little late for her performance of "I'm So Tired."
Louis, help me here. I'm gonna have to give her something before her performance.
Blow it off, Cole. These artsy-fartsy types always get a little flighty. Meet Dr. Harlan Fontaine, doctor to the stars. Mr. Fix-It to the
Cole's like, Roy,
Hollywood.
Every group of people do we meet, can you not?
So what about that drink, boys?
You just walked me in a room so you could slap an actress around and then watch me see a doctor shoot her full of drugs.
A doctor who I've been staring at in newspaper memories of terrible things.
But he doesn't know that.
Yeah.
So if you drive yourself there and haul ass, you can actually like kick the dude's asses in the apartment. Like when they're roughing up the place,
you can get there.
6 months later,
there's the
red lipstick murder.
We're up to murders now, boys.
Does that end the case there?
No, but you get a little extra because you give them the what for.
Yeah, it talks about the what for. This is a murder case, even though it involves a car.
So you were saying that the cases before were a little real, huh?
All right, gentlemen, take your seats. Let's get
Now they're starting.
Here he is!
Floyd Rose of the Homicide Squad has decided to take early retirement. We will all miss Floyd and the steely edge he brought to his police work.
Steely
the department
edge.
Has arranged a wee drink at the Galway Arms to quench the mighty thirst a man gets from 25 years of police work. Floyd's departure leaves a place at the top table, and the chief has seen fit to promote Cole Phelps from burglary to the homicide desk.
So we don't even get to do burglary desk.
Yeah.
So look, we've got a snazzy new blue
You're
suit.
You're in the major leagues now, Sonny. Rusty Galloway. Fine lawman of the old school will be taking you under his wing. Your first case is the murder of a woman found last night and bearing all the signs of the werewolf. Get out to the scene, lads.
Beat up that werewolf.
Oh, man.
Rusty Galloway.
I'm tired of Saberwolf killing all our women.
Say a prayer and get out there and do the Lord's work.
Speaking of prayer, just pray he doesn't team up with John Talbain.
Oh, snap.
Like, I feel like that's the kind of guy that, like, drops onto the crime scene and does unlimited blade works in the middle of
everything.
It's so stupid.
So our your desk is in a different place, so you're super confused about where to go.
Yeah.
So about these murder cases now.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like they're gonna be showing me how the murder goes down for extra pizumph.
Well, they showed you how a lot of those traffic cases went down at the very beginning.
Yeah, I guess so.
Unfortunately, and this is highly important, you can't use your pre-case murder vision as
you
evidence.
Address. It's been all over KGPL.
It doesn't.
Temple Street.
That only applies to us, the
yes.
viewer.
What happened to Rose?
Parker wants the chief's job. Word is it's either going to be him or Thad Green. So they're both clearing the decks.
So where does that leave you, Galloway?
Leaves me saddled with a chump like you, Phelps.
Ooh.
I didn't ask for you, and I don't want you, so keep it to yourself.
Fair enough.
See if you can learn something about seeing how a real cop operates.
What did he mean by the
But I solved like five murders.
The Daily News came
in
out
traffic.
The werewolf killer. The Examiner came up with the Black Dahlia.
Mm. Are
we any closer to catching him?
Not a chance. 6 months and hundreds of guys running down leads, we got nothing.
Oh, that's cool.
I think this has anything to do with it.
No, I don't. 90% of murders are domestic, Phelps. some guy gets into a beef with his wife, he takes it too far. It's gonna be the same. But cutting someone in half and leaving them off the sidewalk, that's a one-off. Why so many women this year? Because of the war. You should know that. Guy gets to kill people every day in combat. Comes home, he's expected to take a lift from his wife. What do you think's gonna happen? It's that simple. Like I said, most of the time it is.
So I think by the end of murder cases, he kind of warms up to Cole maybe a little bit.
Yeah, sure, sure, I believe it. You know,
but he's old and he's tired.
Sojiro's doing the same thing.
Yeah,
I get it.
Rusty fuck.
But the background of your cases being the Black Dahlia is fucking great.
How about a scoop for the
that is solid.
Pumping in a little bit of real world stuff always helps.
Is the werewolf back in business, boys?
But it's like everything. It was the sickest case.
Respect for this poor woman.
Like sickest isn't bad.
And Detective Galloway will give you a statement later.
He's good, Rusty. He even sounds genuine.
That's Phelps, guys. The war hero. Defending the honor of murdered humps.
You're used to it, Phelps. Moving along, guys. You got your pictures, you got your headlines. Now scram.
I love Rusty.
Like, you made Body Detective right on the time when all detectives are, like, fucking going nuts, running in circles. Speaking of which.
Yeah. So, Wooly, you were talking about realness before.
Yeah.
I think Billy might need to put, like, a matter pat head on top of that.
Yeah, don't worry about it.
Yeah, no, we have to worry about it for heavy rain.
Oh, we did, huh? Yeah.
Kids park here. They use it like a lover's lane. It's a working neighborhood. Some trouble, but nothing like this. It's known locally as the Moors.
It's the Moops. On the
scene? Yes, Detective.
The Moops.
No one's disturbed the body.
No, sir. We cleared out them vulture reporters so Pinker and the coroner could work. They're waiting to talk to you.
Go out the house and see what you come up with.
Hey, coroner, I bet you have tons of shit to tell me.
I actually don't.
No,
I don't
misplaced
know
Ubisoft textures this time around.
Look at all this shit.
What can you tell me about the shoe prints? Men's size 8s. Pinker lifted impressions.
Shoe prints are fascinating to me. As you can tell, somebody's weight, their height, their stride,
it's
all
cool.
Sorts of shit.
It's not just the type of shoe.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
I watch a TV show and I'm like, oh, shoe prints. I'm like, oh, trades their shoes? It's like, well, no. It's you can learn a lot, actually.
Man, the gait of the person that was walking here must have been David Flair.
Apparently, the perp was crip walking.
Interesting.
Looks brand new.
Yep, that's a
Can't
bullet.
Be the one used on the body.
That means the killer brought his own lipstick.
When I murder, I need to look good.
It's more than passion if you beat the body down and then fucking strip it and do all that other shit.
Oh yeah, no. Crimes of passion are really simple to understand, right? Even crimes of profit are easy to understand, right? But crimes of compulsion are something altogether different. What a weird piece of fucking weirdo shit. Solve the puzzle, Wooly.
I don't know what the world looks like.
Most people don't.
I sure don't. Aha! One more.
Oh, two more.
I'll put Canada right up on top of that China.
Yeah.
The way it belongs.
Shenanada.
Staring at Japan. That's how
One more. Okay, now you gotta go down.
Yeah, no, that's good.
The bottom one's a little fucked up because Australia.
Go.
Down. No, I mean down.
All the way
There's
bottom,
a fourth
yes.
one.
Which I can't actually get
to. Oh, you gotta redo the whole thing.
You gotta,
set position.
You gotta do what the bottom tells you.
Stupid South America telling me what to do.
Click.
God damn it.
And they make clicks when you got them right.
I wonder what's gonna be in here. I honestly don't remember a huge amount of these cases.
Pangea?
It was Pangea!
Nailed it. I've cracked the case.
It was the world that did
Aha,
it.
Aha! Magic!
Dio, the Bomba Club.
Bomba Club. Why steal a table lighter?
That's a fucking
Light
weird
my
one.
Cigarettes.
Why do you have to solve a puzzle to fucking...
Shh.
For variety.
It's interesting.
Da-na-na.
A cigarette butt, eh?
See, in the future, that would have actually been highly valuable, yeah, but nowadays, nonsense.
If you told these cops about DNA, they'd be like, who's Denaya?
Ah.
This is going to help us.
That's bullshit, because sometimes matchbooks are like the biggest, most useful piece of
information. Yeah, we've used them in cases before.
Because they always have bar addresses.
Looks like you got the non-body related ones.
Yeah, I guess this is a piece of evidence too.
Yeah, it's kind of big.
Death? Could be the head injuries.
Now let's be a little more respectful than the other ones.
Or we can just do like cops have to do and like turn their brain off, crack jokes about it so that you don't fucking cry.
The ultimate isn't the cops. The ultimate is surgeons and doctors.
Yeah.
Autopsy.
Yeah. He's just like, oh yeah, look, I got a spleen.
Oh, hi-ho. This guy's a big drinker, huh?
That's like those big, that's like those goofy episodes of X-Files where Scully is removing pizza from people's stomachs and then she's like, I'm so hungry, and then she orders a bunch of pizza.
Yeah. Alright, ring ripped off.
It takes a special kind of person to care about people enough to dig around in them after they're dead to find out what got them. Yeah, girl, you got all fucked up.
What caused the blunt force injury in your face? Could be anything from a baseball bat to a lug wrench. I'll have more details after the autopsy.
Yeesh.
That's
a real big shiner.
Good job, Rockstar. That's a body, man.
And the fucking text is the weirdest part.
Interesting.
BD.
Fuck you, BD. Can't see what the rest of that says.
Looks like you need to talk to the coroner.
Yeah. Alright, so
that's
we got
like a weird scar in her abdomen where
head.
It kind of looks like someone sewed a cell phone.
Yeah, it looks like you got him.
Okay. Heads and shoulders, knees and toes.
Oh, you got it.
Like Dahlia, Tex, your guess is as good as mine. Could be something to it, or could be the killers trying to throw you off the scent. Mm. Either way, I'll run tests on the lipstick.
Oh, yeah, that could be a good reason to.
From the temperature, I'd say.
Oh, yeah, it's for open season. Everybody's looking for that guy.
Can we get to the bottom?
Yeah, so, like, when serial killers, like, really came about, like, publicly, you know? Like, what an easy thing to do where it's like, I'll make fake evidence to make you think I'm someone else.
Yeah. Respectful, Wooly, respectful!
And eyes and ears and mouth and nose.
I love how Rusty...
You got everything.
Like, you do this, and you're looking at this brain matter, and then Rusty's like, can we get to the next place? I need a drink.
I need a big burger.
What, like, why would they not have flasks in their pockets? Get out
of
here.
Yeah, that's true.
Like, Rusty, if he's been working homicide for, like, 15, 20 years, yeah, he'd be fucking used to it. He wouldn't give a goddamn shit. The Bamba Club.
Go to the Werewolf Club.
I love werewolves.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
It's back!
Oh, no!
It's back, baby!
It's the return!
Please, damn it!
Run!
Time to teach this partner.
Everyone's thoughts! The Cole Phelps way!
He hasn't had a chance to meet me!
And there ain't nothing like me!
Here we go!
Rusty, I you know, there's some rumors about me from traffic.
I'm here to tell you they're all true. All of it.
All of it.
There's a difference, Rusty.
Oh, yeah?
I just started working it today.
Okay. Oh, God, what an asshole.
More like,
damn.
Come back around, then you get some known in court.
He clearly has a thing for power. Power over women. Why not power over the police department as well?
Lots of serial killers like fucking with the police department.
After 6 months of stoop. There's some opportunist who's been reading about the BD figures. He'll rip off the MO and get himself a freebie.
That's not totally fantastic.
An examiner of the Daily News might be good at coming up with monikers, but they're terrible for police work. There's a reason we didn't get the son of a bitch after the short murder was them, locusts.
Where do you think the werewolf killer is now?
Dead by his own hand, stationed somewhere else with the armed forces. San Quentin, another town, another country, who knows? So, Phelps, I understand you want to turn this into a big case, but it doesn't work like that, all right? A case will come and find you. Can't make it something today. Understand?
Hmm. So you don't think the werewolf has continued to operate in the Los Angeles area?
No chance. We'll have found him.
Yeah, the thing about California is it's a very small state.
I actually really like the, one of the implications that Rusty gives is that the Black Dahlia killer might totally just be in prison on a different unrelated crime.
Oh, yeah.
And that's why there's no chance of catching him.
Right.
Because you caught him.
He's behind bars.
Holy shit!
I'm back!
That cop is crazy!
Back to Rise!
Know my name.
Because, like, flaunting in front of the police, like, the BTK killer was also the head of the neighborhood watch.
Yeah.
And would be on TV telling people, like, hey,
watch out
careful.
For the BTK.
Watch out for, like, hey, you know, close your windows.
Yeah,
and, like,
yeah.
And then he would be on TV constantly just saying, like, hey, I'm the head of security. I'm telling you, everyone, you gotta do this. And he was all like, ah, you cops, you didn't know all the time. And since they didn't find him for so long, he got really, really, really bored. And then just sent a note and just left his fingerprints all over and got caught that day. He's a fucking idiot.
And then he was shocked about it. He was like, I thought you were too dumb.
Yeah. Yeah, we don't get less, we don't get more dumb in 20 years.
You my coffee next time, honey.
We couldn't figure it out, but then we figured it out.
In like a second.
Because we got technology now.
Meanwhile, Robert Durst walks
free. Were you working here last night?
Yes.
Yeah. Poor Fred.
Help, officer. You can start with your name. Garrett Mason. You're the regular bartender on nights?
I'm a temporary barman. I work for an agency. I fill in at bars across town.
Do you remember a woman who came in here last night? 5'7", about 110 pounds, blonde hair, about 40 years of age.
You mean Celine Henry?
I'll write that down.
Yes. Do you know anything about her?
I don't. But the owner, Mr. McCall, serves her most nights. Would you like to speak to him?
I would.
He sits at the back of the club, wears a hibiscus. You can't miss him.
He wears a plant on his head?
Is there anything else?
Fire away, Phelps. I'll stay here. I'm a little parched.
There you go.
Pour me three fingers of rye.
Fucking rye? In the middle of the afternoon?
I know, that's some heavy shit, man.
The lighting cue.
Oh, it's that guy.
You can't miss it. Right. Hey, guy.
He's wearing a hibiscus.
Detective Phelps, LAPD. We're investigating the murder of Celine Henry. Do you know her?
Celine? Christ.
Are you going to pay for that?
Sure I know her. She and I and Jacob, her husband, we go way back.
She was here last night?
Sure, she's a regular. Celine is... was a... lovely woman.
I love that you can hear Rusty, like, not paying for his drink.
Was Henry here with anyone last night?
Not at first. Celine already had quite a head start.
But she attracted attention?
Certainly. A few gentlemen became very enamored with her and her stories. One guy in particular.
Truth.
But maybe.
He's thinking about it, but it seems truthful.
What do we got? We got a lighter.
You have nothing.
Running out missing jewelry.
It's either truth or doubt.
I believe it.
You know him?
No. He's been in a couple of times.
Did they leave together?
Yes. At around 11. If it helps, I made the guy's
that
license.
May be the most helpful thing possible.
That's absurd.
Well, back in the day, people used to do that.
Well, because, like, all the movies I watched in the 80s and, like, 90s and shit, it was, like, the number one way to get criminals.
Also, like, that's an easy one to remember. 2B8899?
Yep.
It's crazy easy to remember.
Almost as easy as hentai.
Yeah. That was a great license plate.
Mrs. Henry appeared to be missing a ring, torn from her finger, but not her wedding finger.
Celine always wore a red garnet ring on the large side. Larger than life, like Celine herself.
You like Celine.
Did she have it
a
long time?
I like
her. Sure. Since way back in her flying days.
Did her husband buy it for her?
No, it was before Jacob.
I think you know where the ring came from.
You got it for it, didn't you?
Okay.
Yeah.
I bought it years ago. I carried a torch for Celine in those days. I guess I always have. Her old man never knew about it.
Oh.
Do you have knowledge of Jacob?
You know the husband?
Sure I know Jacob. He was in the Corps. He met Celine on a furlough and married her when the war was finished. Put up with a load of shit.
Okay.
Do you think he killed his wife?
No. No, not in my opinion.
Yeah, true.
Was he ever violent with her?
Celine
Sorry, that just looked like a slam dunk.
No, I thought so too.
They don't live together anymore, so it might not have been him.
Then it must have been doubt.
Thanks, so yeah.
Evidence.
I'm starting to realize. So what I'm starting to think, your face isn't enough.
No, it's not.
Not all the time.
142 North Union Avenue. God knows I had to send her home in enough cabs to remember that.
All right, you got her address.
I have another spoon.
There's a phone there though, but I don't know exactly.
Always
what
use
you
the
need
phone icon when you see it.
I guess so. Maybe asking for the
phone is highly helpful.
Maybe asking for the address of Jacob or something. But I mean, I thought that's what you just got.
Let's get out of here.
There's a phone.
Hey, what's the hurry?
There was an item there.
The stool was just starting to warm up nicely.
The fuck is that?
Good to me.
Oh, check.
It's just a bunch of shit.
Just a bunch of shit.
I need this phone.
Wait,
what? Not that phone.
That's ridiculous.
Operator, give me R&I.
I can't believe it.
I've never seen anything so crazy.
Phelps badge 1247.
How could I help you?
Now, it lets you, you know, expedite the fucking car segment. But sometimes it'd be nice to, like, speed these up.
I don't mind them.
Well, I mean, we're not doing anything.
No, but I'm paying attention.
Thanks for your help.
Not so much, because you either get the information that's added to your ledger and you don't actually have to hear what she has to say. Or she tells you, call back in a little bit, and you get it anyway.
I forgot it was broad daylight. Fucking
yeah, it was pretty dark in there.
Jeez, you
I need a fucking drink, and it needs to be night.
Ah, you alcoholics.
All right. bar's a weird place. There are certain times of day that you can walk in and go, everyone in here is a piece of shit!
And they go, hey, Pat.
There's a timeline.
Back again.
There is a timeline back in the day in which I become Norm and or Cliff.
Which way do you lean?
Cliff.
All right.
A smart lawyer might use that to throw out anything you collect today.
A smart man might know it's unwise to stand between your patient and his medicine.
As long as you're not falling over, Rusty, I'll let it slide.
That's mighty kind. No, you picked the wrong job of a healthy thirst of vengeance.
We owe it to this city to do the best we can in this position.
You need to be on the murder desk for longer, Cole.
Is all the more serious.
Always the politician.
It's not political, it's practical. Maybe the men combing Hollywood Boulevard after the Elizabeth Short murder were more interested in sniffing out booze. The clues that led to her killing.
Oh, man.
Yeah, well, if only you'd been there, Clark.
Shabamzos.
Betty Short would be alive, the chap would have spared Pearl Harbor. Our ancestors wouldn't have tasted the forbidden fruit.
Minor syntactical error, Detective Galloway. I never claimed to be able to prevent crimes. I only suggested a proficiency in solving them. Guess that's the drink slowing you down.
Oh my god, brother, oh brother. Worse than I could ever imagine.
The straightest of straight
Phelps
edges.
Is such an asshole.
Like, razor sharp.
Phelps is the special kind of asshole in that he's completely right. And I hate him. Right?
Well, because no one wants a square.
He's so squarey, I'm cutting myself on his edges.
Yeah, why can't you just let me booze up on the job to protect and serve?
Yeah, no, that's the ridiculous part, because on the other end of the argument is someone that's currently drinking in the car. You know?
A couple of road sodas. What's the problem with a couple of road sodas?
Oh, I've never heard that one before. That's new. I'm going to use that.
I'm sorry, choir boy. Among my road sodas offending you?
Oh,
yes.
I'm sorry. Did you like it? Fuck yeah. It's like. Oh.
You sound like one of those hobos in like a GTA game.
I do sound like that. But also, I did a funny voice just now.
Or a final fight, streetwise. Fragment Savage. My new Slim Knot album.
There's a new one?
There's always a moment.
Back then, during Final Fight Streetwise, they have all
Slipknot
those...
refuses to die. Yeah, just right through this person's fucking house.
Watch where fuck you! I'm the Lord God.
Is the fence breakable? No!
Nothing is.
You've trapped yourself again, fellas!
Run outside and then call for an additional backup car.
Alright, check this out.
Yeah, yeah?
Oh! Let's see if it works.
I like this.
I want to see. Oh, I didn't want to teleport. I wanted to see him like fight to get out. Oh,
I wanted it too.
It would have been good.
Again, Wooly, that's an LP funsy. That's what I want to
see. Yeah, that's the good stuff.
The results.
It's warming up to Phelps.